Hello friends, welcome one and all. Today we will be looking into the second chapter of the State Board's textbook, The Thief's Story by Ruskin Bond, 1935. And let me tell you, he's still alive. A young boy makes friends with Anil. Anil trusts him completely and employs him. Does the boy betray the trust? Let's have a look. The story is about a 15-year-old thief who changes his name every month to stay ahead of the police and old employers. This time, he kept his name Hari Singh. The other person in the story is a 25-year-old writer named Anil. The thieves meet Anil and asks him if he can work with him. The story unfolds on how the thief betrays Anil by committing a theft but retracts later on. This story is about two different people, one a thief of 15 years and a man approximately 25 years watching a wrestling match somewhere. The name of the person watching the match is Anil. The thief approaches Anil and starts talking to him because he feels that he has not robbed anyone in the past few days and thought that it would be easy to rob a simple person like Anil. They both start talking and Anil asks the thief his name. The thief introduces himself as Hari Singh. This is not his real name as he changes his name every month to escape from his ex-employers and police. They then start talking about the wrestling and Anil was leaving when Hari called him and asked him if he could work for Anil. Anil said he won't be able to pay but could feed him if he knew how to cook. Hari had lied that he knew to cook. Anil took Hari to his room, which was above a sweet shop. Hari cooked a meal which was really bad because Anil did not eat it. Anil asked Hari to leave, but he tried to please Anil. Hari smiled in the most attractive way and Anil could not stop laughing at him. Anil agreed to teach Hari how to cook, write full sentences and add numbers. Hari was grateful as he knew that there would be no limit to robbing people once he had learned how to read and write. As we all know, this is the thief's story, so Hari Singh is the thief who is the narrator. The narrator used to like working for Anil as he used to make him tea in the morning and then go to buy the grocery for the day. He also used to steal 1 rupee from the money that was given to him to buy groceries. Anil knew that he used to steal but did not mind. Anil used to make money by regular works. Sometimes he used to borrow money and the other days when he did have money, he used to lend it to other people. Whenever he used to get money, he would go out with his friends to celebrate. One day, Anil came with his bundle of notes and told Hari that he had sold a book to a publisher. At night, he kept the money safely under the mattress of his bed. Hari realized that he has been working for Anil for more than a month and had not stolen anything apart from the 1 rupee that he kept every day for the grocery money. Hari had many chances to steal as he had the keys to the room, but he was surprised with the amount of trust Anil had on him and he had never seen such a trusting person in his life. This trusting thing was preventing him from robbing Anil. As Hari thought, robbing a careless person like Anil did not make much of a difference because he might not even notice that he has been robbed and took out all the fun of the work. Then he thought of stealing Anil's money and justify himself that if he did not steal his money, Anil would anyways waste it on his friends. Anil did not pay him the work that he did. Hari then woke up at night and quietly crawled to Anil's bed. He steals the money and decides to leave the city by Lucknow Express that departs at 10:30. When he reaches the station, the train slowly started moving from the platform. He could have easily caught the train, but he hesitated and he himself did not know the reason for it. Before he had reached the station, he counted the money and it was 600 rupees in 50 rupees notes. He would live a lavish life for 2 to 3 weeks with so much money. After the train had left, Hari was all alone at the station. He was left with no place to sleep at night. The only person he knew was Anil, and he had saluted him as well. He sat on a bench in a park, and as it sat, it started raining. He sat down under the clock tower. Then he realized that the notes have got wet. He realized that learning how to read and write would help him to much more respectable and honest job, which would pay him much more than these few hundred rupees. Then he decided to go back to Anil's house. He reached the room and placed the money back. Next morning, he had woken up a bit late, only to realize that Anil had already made him a tea. Anil gave a 50 rupee note to Hari as he had not paid him for some other work. He would be paid regularly now. Hari took the note in his hand and realized that the note was still wet from the last night's rain. Hari realized that Anil has come to know about his misdeed, but there was no sadness, anger or guilt in his mind. The narrator smiled in a beautiful way, and it was genuine happiness that he knew that he had saved himself from the wrong road. So this marked the end of the chapter, The Thief's Story. Thank you. I hope you liked it, and if you did, do like and subscribe my channel, Expressophilia. Stay tuned.